Simmons. Message by you to inviting me is Turtle Will. You can find him on Facebook at True Turtle Empires. Thanks to Dust Shelves for sponsoring Audible Studios, where we're recording that in the South Bronx. So check it out. So that TV series, we're coming to you right now. La Rue!
Shut my mouth. All about fear of attraction, my civil right. It's my right. Down the sight, out the sight. Throwing that eagle's height, eagle's height. Take out water in lights. Pray for better life.
Welcome to the Soap Dot TV series. Once again, I'm Dirty Promessa. We got the wonderful, talented artist.
Turtle Will,
yeah, guys. Let him introduce himself, man. How you doing, Turtle Will? We're bringing Turtle Will to the Soap Dot TV show. He came, wanted to support it. Want to support what's going on with Dirty Promessa and the Takeover Promotion brand. And you know what I'm saying? We're filming up right now at Audible Studios, man, located 381 Canal Place, Bronx, New York, 10451. Thanks to the promoter and the sponsor of that, Dutch Schultz. So, you know, man, this is what we're doing, man. Soap Dot TV series, bringing it to you every weekly, 4 o'clock, every Thursday, 4 o'clock, and 11 o'clock now, up on Brooklyn Cable Networks. Right now, channel Time Warner, 56, RCN, 84, Verizon Fios, 44, and my optimum is 67, 68, and 69. Once again, Soap Dot TV series airs every Thursday at 4 o'clock. Check it out. I'm starting new projects for Takeover Promotions, Dirty Promessa, and we're doing much more things than just music, you know what I'm saying? So right here, I met up with this guy, man, Turtle Will from the Bronx. You know, like I always say, the Bronx still got it. We still got talent over here doing what he's doing. And I met up with him at an open mic. So he came, we got together, we put something together. We got the open mic on Mondays. We got the Haven SBX.
Haven SBX Art Gallery, and it wasn't just any open mic, my guy.
Yeah.
It was the third week. The 3 is my favorite number, by the way, in case you do not know this. I break the fourth wall. I'm talking to the audience, all right, guys. But it was the third week, and you had came in, and you was like, "Who's open mic is this? What's going on?" I told you it was mine, and now we made Legacy, and I believe that's becoming a TV series as well, right?
Yeah, it's going to be on. It's going to be on. Going to find out the program date. But everybody, if you faithfully a fan, just watch out to take out promotion, the Turtle Empire, True Turtle Empire on Facebook
as truest.
Well. You know what I'm saying? We basically link up. We link up and we always promote whatever ventures we're doing for that week. We always also produce a show you can check out right now on the YouTube subscription at Dirty Promessa. Weekly episodes, weekly events of artists that came to the open mic and they basically performed.
We've had the Lord of the Ciphers.
Lord of the Ciphers.
Do you know what that means? Do you know what that means? In all ciphers, he's God. He's the Lord of the Cipher. I'm just saying this is the type of support system that you get here in the Bronx. Like you get people like that, and that's just a beautiful thing to see how highly people can think of themselves and actually own up to a title, and that's beautiful.
You sound real psychic, man, and this beautiful lady, Super Puff. Remember that? Big shout out Banco, yo, J.O.
Uzi, Banco.
You know what I'm saying? Who else was up in there? Brian.
We got Cool Quest.
Cool Quest. Who else is up in there?
Yo, boy. We had Mookie, the preacher.
Oh man, the preacher man talks rap.
He does talk rap. That's why he's a preacher. You
You're damn right. It goes with his title.
Exactly.
Shit,
I love that guy.
You know what I'm saying? Awesome. So what brings you, other than that, what brings you up to this far of supporting me and the Takeover Promotions with the Soap Dot TV series? Like, what do you believe? I have to ask. What do you believe in what I'm doing that just energizes you and say, yo, I'm going to support my man right here. He's going and help him do what he has to do to strive.
Okay, let me tell you why. Because you're doing this. This is a goal, correct?
Goal.
This is like a goal well like executed, correct?
Pretty much.
Yeah.
Doing my best.
And I'm a huge fan in goals. I realize what's my favorite thing in the world? Goals. How do I go about that? I complete them. Mm-hmm. Okay, cool. I've always wanted. Hey, Chris Tucker, if you're watching this, I've always wanted to take your role as like I want to be the next Chris Tucker.
Because
I just want you to know, like, seriously, I've always been in like entertaining. I just like being able to like take over a crowd. So, you know, I started.
How young were you when you felt that way, man? Like, you're a young dude now. You know what I'm saying?
My entire life, honestly, actually, because I remember. I'm entertaining people, like I said, that's been my thing. I remember back when I was a kid, I would actually... I think I was maybe like between 8 and 10, I can't really recall. Mm-hmm. But I just know, and I think I've just been, actually, between 8 and 10, just ever since I've been playing with toys. So I remembered I would have my sister actually watch these bullcrap movies I would make up. Like in my head, and they were all original.
Sisters in the house. Big shout out to sisters.
Big shout out to my sister, Rena.
She's on the side. You know what I'm saying?
She's actually here. She's waving at me.
Big shout out. Say hey.
Hey.
You can hear her.
We'll probably get up in here before the segment. She was a little bashful about coming on to the cameras. You know what I'm saying? All lights and shit.
She wasn't expecting to be on screen.
Well, you ain't got to be censored on this. You know what I'm saying? I know you don't curse a lot, but at the same time, it's freedom of speech.
So I'm able to say... Am I able to say sugar?
Bitch ass motherfucker, suck my shit.
Whoa. I just don't want to sound like a non-intelligent
guy. Your shit would still get hit. Don't worry about it.
I just don't want to sound like a non-intelligent guy getting arrested, you know?
So how you like the studio, man? I love it,
but do you know what a non-intelligent guy getting arrested is? It's my acronym for the N-word. Break it down.
I'm sorry. I'm a brick right now.
But I honestly,
the weather's fucked up outside, isn't it?
I won't talk about it.
Yo, today weather had me fucked up today.
But
like,
as far as the studio is concerned, I'm in love with it. Like, right now, like, we're working with guys. This isn't real. This is all green
don't
screen.
Tell them my shit.
I'm sorry. Okay. That being said, behind the green screen there is an actual New York sign, and I just look at that and I'm like,
you want New York? You want New York behind us?
Yeah.
You want to
New
see
York?
It?
New York is a. I mean.
I gotta go. Put that there.
Yeah, yeah. Actually, can we green screen the actual behindness of what's going on? Yeah, that would be beautiful. All right,
you know what? I could do that.
Yeah, that would be beautiful.
That would take some time, but you always try to make me do a fucking music video, man.
I'm sorry, man. I'm just weird.
Yo, every time he comes over, while I'm working and shit, he comes over, because this motherfucker be having me doing some other shit, because he's talented. I ain't mind even going front. The boy's talented. You know what I'm saying? You can check him out. True Turtle Empire. Before I met him, he already had stuff out.
Yeah,
so it's like, you know.
Like, it's True Turtle Empire. And like I said, well, as far as the whole, like, how long I've been doing this, like, I've basically been doing this pretty much all my life. And, like, I only recently started to actually take a stand for it, you know. Like, actually say, hey, you know what? I write. Mm-hmm. I like making people laugh. I like being able to just control the situation. So I got on the train one day, literally just did that. Couple months passed, I'm still doing that. I got a couple guys, you know.
Yeah, followed you, man. We did that, followed you. I wanted to see that shit.
Yo,
I wanted to see what it was. I know it as busking. You know what I'm saying? I wanted to the opportunity to follow you. We went throughout the train system. Nigga made money. I ain't asked for a fucking dime. The dude did his thing. I wanted to know. I can't do that.
It's really easy.
I can't.
It's just about left.
So
let's take a stand.
To follow you,
I understand. You can totally do that, because you know how I know you can totally do that. You're doing it right now.
This is exactly
the dream right here. What you're doing is exactly where I want to be in life. And through that process of the trains, I ran into this woman I call the Rhythm Mystic. Shouts out to Rose Angel, because that's her real name. Rose Angelica Lopez, she's freaking beautiful. Basically, she actually put me on to this whole hosting thing, the whole being able to control the party. She actually put me on to that, because I remember she was running an open mic and she had seen me on the train. You know, I don't have nothing or whatever. She literally said, hey, come to my event. The event costs money to get in.
Yeah, yeah.
She like, yo, She's not even there, mind you. I go. She's not even there when I get there. Like, she gets there later, but when I get there, she's not even there because I got there mad early. And the people, I tell them who I am, and the people are like, oh, you're Tori Wilson. Yeah, you're good. Like, you're good. What? I was like, they open mic.
Well, it was a strip club, bro.
No, I'm serious. Yeah.
Yo, we got 20 seconds. Yo, we're going to go into a commercial early break right here. This sold out TV series of Dirty Promessa, Turtle Wheel.
Who's your vampire? Check that out.
DP! Top! Shut my mouth!
I just wanted to tell you that your angel is the one that will guide you into the mysterious realm that will become your love life. And that, my friend, that's where the journey ends. Because she'll then fly you into a future you realize was just made up of your own decisions. And these choices, they can't always make a miracle happen. So it's always hard to believe in vision until that sun ray rises up to shed a little light on the mission. And that is to take over the empire. And every emperor should have an empress. My blood is feeling kind of royal, so whatever. I deserve the best. And with women, I'm trying to do a bit more than thinking breasts. I'm trying to get inside your soul so I can spiritually caress. And you're twice the woman and I'm twice the man. We could be a fantastic force for connect. And everything I know thus far is just based off a theory in my head on what would happen if I chose to be committed. Now I'm cool with all of my exes. Because I consider the blessings. Beautiful blessings that were spawned from a powerful friendship. Wondering if we can make love without me having to kill. Because anybody can get see. But I'm trying to see if it's lovable. Now, we live in a day and age where men date the same woman and her name is Bae. My boy is trying to convince me that every girl is the same. They'll try to tell them, find that unique chick and trust me, homies. She'll change the whole game. Thank you all for your respect. Guys, if you like what you heard, that was an original piece written by Mawad. I go by the name of Turtle Will. You can find my information by searching me up on Google, True Turtle Empire, or on Facebook, True Turtle Empire. Along by my side on the camera, my man, Dirty Promessa.
Welcome back to the Soul Talk TV series. I'm Dirty Promessa. Thank you for the support of Dutch Shelts, Turtle Will, True Turtle Empire. You can find them on Facebook. You can find me on Facebook at Takeover Promotions. We up right now at Waterman Studios. Anybody who needs sessions, you need to be just some space, some time, throw a party, an event, check out Waterman Studios at 381 Canal Place, Bronx, New York, 10451. Right now, you're watching the Soul TV series. I'm Dirty Promessa, and you heard already from the talented Turtle Will. And we're back from a little intermission because, you know, we need time to water our dopes and shit,
cleanse
and get our thoughts together, because everything is exciting, is wild. Being on Soul Talk TV series, man, you get to air it out, no censored. This is what we do up in here, man. So, what was it you asked me during intermission that you wanted to know, you wanted me to do? Introduce what? The go-getter?
Oh my God, why did you even bring that up? Maybe you could have forgotten that I said that, but yeah. But yeah, the thing about it, I don't like go-getter.
Why not?
It's just a matter of, like, everybody likes it, apparently. And apparently it's the best, which means I can't write better.
You know.
Yeah. Come here, I want to talk to you. Come here, I want to talk to you. You see, I feel like we could do more stuff than just in the bedroom. What did you think the reason was for me stopping you? You see, I thought you had desires and I just want those dreams to come true. How did I know I got the same ones too? You see, I was hoping to find a man that said, hey, it might be you. Now, since I saw your thoughts, I saw my reflection. So, well, baby, I'm trying to show you my greatest side of affection. Because way back in the day, my mama taught me a lesson to love myself and count all of my blessings. Yes, I believe in heaven since I survived hell and the days have been getting pleasant. I mean, look, I met you. I'm so happy you came through. I actually wanted to go outside to meet a pretty girl much like you. And I would like to fit you up on my schedule. But if that's all right with you, now, pardon me, I'm rude because we've yet to introduce. Your name is? Hi, my name is William Edward Graham III, and I love the sound of your name in my verse. And can I immortalize you with my words? And can you manifest my universe? I want to know if you can make it better, don't make it worse. Besides, I've already dealt with her. If you're my story, I'll be your narrator. So listen, girl, you're beautiful. And if you look behind that mirror, you know those soul muscles are wonderful. And I'm trying to get to know you more than any man you've ever dealt with before. That's factual. I'm trying to touch your soul. Pardon me if I got too personal, I'm just emotional and on this Drakey flow. That's why I wrote the poem, because I had to approach you with more than, ayo. See, you've been invading my dreaming. See, you've been affecting my thinking. I had you on the mind when I wrote this rhyme, and I say this is an achievement. Because if I was to ask you to kiss me, I wouldn't even care if you dissed me. Because I know how much you're worth, because I put in the words, and you're the reason why they have meaning. So they say, I'm a go-getter, watch me go-getter, I need to. Go getter, if I'm a go getter, you should go getter. If you a go getter, watch me. Go getter, I need to go getter. Excuse me, but the matter of fact is, you see, I haven't been introduced to every girl that's on the X or Y axis, but I've been introduced to the letter U, which is why I need to ask this. Do you believe you're the prettiest girl in the room?
Yes.
Huh, because if you didn't, you won't believe what I'm about to tell you. And I need to know if you're into creativity.
Yes.
Me too. And do you like watching movies?
Of course.
So we should go out just so I could watch one with you. And that could either be a date or we could call each other theater mates. All I know is if I don't bother to ask you why, I'm going to be quite frustrated because I need to know if you're willing to do something unique a little later. Now, I stand at the front of her friend zone. Just gazing upon this woman on her throne, wondering to myself, is there any reason for this queen to be alone? But you go ahead and do that royal independent thing. But let there ever come a time when you have thoughts of a king, I'll be standing at the front of your zone just so that I can be seen. And if I am to be dubbed, your song is always the one that I sing. Because they say, I'm a go-getter, watch me go-getter, I need to go-getter. If I'm a go-getter, you should go-getter. If you a go-getter, watch me go-getter now. Did I get ya? Did I get ya?
You originally wrote it, right?
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
I know you have sound in mind about other people's pieces and shit that you performed.
I write and on the trains now, since I got my own like open mic and I host stuff now, I kinda, it's not to like stroke my ego or anything when I say I don't feel like I'm the shit, but necessarily I just don't feel the need to perform my stuff anymore on the train, because I've always had this my biggest fear is just being on the train doing my stuff and someone takes it. So now that I host my own open mic, I thought, okay, I'm going to recite my favorite artist, which is Whit Lowry.
Yeah, you did some good pieces yesterday.
Yeah, when I did the train, there's this song called Wonder If You Wonder that I recite on the train. And you guys are in Brooklyn, right? Yeah, you'll see me sometimes. I'll literally be on the train just doing my stuff, and I come in. And I like to.
You said you had a favorite train, the 5.
The 5 train.
Yo, he was down packed with the train system too, man. That's what I. This shit, right, like, he knew which ones wasn't gonna rock. He told me before we even got on, like, don't even get on the D train.
Have some money. I'm not gonna lie.
He's like, don't even get on the D train because the D train too loud. You know what? I ride that motherfucking D train faithfully, yo, like, every fucking Wednesday. And I never realized how loud that bitch was until he said that shit.
It really is.
And that motherfucker is loud. Like, the D train is a loud fucking train. I thought it was, to me, it's a white train. I thought this shit was coasting. I never paid attention. I always, like,
I understand. Like, I didn't notice it, too, until I was actually trying to talk over it. Like when I have to actually like perform for these people. Like I'm like, okay.
Well, so you set up you set a piece of self up on the train in a certain spot, but on the D train the shit was just dumb fucking loud. Like I ain't gonna lie, cause we waited in not looking like we came together. You know what I'm saying? So we basically I stood to the side to film him. Every time he had talked to the right side, and I still was on the left side, I couldn't hear him.
I do this.
I knew what he was saying because I know, you know, and I get, you know.
Like I said, I recite with Lowry. So just imagine you're on the train right now, and this is literally just what I did. I came in just like.
So this guy, Mike, who's against
Whit Lowry? Whit Lowry. Is he? I believe W-I-T-T space L-O-W-R-Y. I might be misspelling it, but,
and you say his piece is what? Why you say his piece is because you
say because right? Like if you ever listen to Go Getter,
yeah,
my own piece.
This will be like we get back.
So like I was saying, just like that piece is talking about a girl that like you know I'm not necessarily sure if I could get or it's just a basically like a girl. So just like a girl who's just a girl. She won't be my girlfriend.
You think if you recite the shit right now live?
Yeah, I'm gonna recite.
I'm
giving you a shout.
I mean,
because
you do
with Lowry. I'm saying your name right now on television. I want you to understand that song. I love to recite it because this is how I come on the train. I'm show you exactly. Then like you said, on the train,
You can do it with sitting down. You can do it sitting down?
Yeah, I
could do it. This nigga stomping his
body. Could I stand up?
Nah, because the camera's centered.
I can't stand up. Okay, but just imagine, this is the face, and I'm acting with this.
You're doing your code and everything.
I'm acting.
On the fucking train, man. You good, man.
So this is what Lowry's song, Wonder If You Wonder.
All right? Like, hey, no. No, I know. I know it's been a long time. I hear you too much is fine. You graduating, got a job, and you've been working the grind. You're never looking behind. I know you never catch me crossing your mind. I'll be lying if you didn't cross mine from time to time. I see some of your pictures online. My kindness regards was hard. I left my heart on the line. I wrote a song for you. And that took a couple months of my time. How could you pay some for flowers and a bottle of wine? You'll never be crying. Now I remember the time I came to see you. I brought you this baby. There's 12 other people you see. There was never a reason. There would be a secret. I remember there'd be a day that day. There'd be any day to see. I remember more than nothing. Love you say you can. The only good connection is never be that you can. I would never try to make you the thing you was aware. Not that you can. But the stress is really starting to wear. And in my music, I took a story and I used it. Didn't care how you was feeling. I'm busy dropping my noodles. No people wanna love it. Fuck that five noodles. I'm into the curse of honesty and the truth. I loved you more than words. I never knew how to prove it. Should've told you that in person, but didn't do my music. Everyone who said they cared is a man. Now I'm confused. Broken the rules. Only open, empty, and stupid. Still, I ought to ponder this. Why would you care? Wonder why I'm alive. Would be the only time you ever were there. See, not all we were friends, but that's all I can pretend is here. It's all been clear that the real honesty is just what I fear. The moment we were only friends and I just act like we dated. So nowadays the conversation is, and every song I wrote for you, I know you actually hate it. Because you realize that you never felt the same when you played it. You never cared if I made it, and that's why I paid it, you know me. See all the love that I've been getting through my phone feel phony. I run my couple words together, now every girl wanna phone me. We in a world full of people that are feeling so lonely. Only I can tell myself it's my mission to see. But this sea is full of sharks, fake gummies, and green. And while I find myself drowning, while I stumble through the green, I realize I'm in love with what I thought you said. What's up, people? If this is your stop and you like that song, look up Wonder If You Wonder, and it was written by Whit Lowry, just like reenacting it, you know? I go by the name of Turtle Well, an entertainer trying to earn a dollar. If you'd like to donate, let me know, because if not, I don't want to beg you for anything I'm trying to earn, because then I don't earn it.
Oh, that That shit even had me like, yo, who the fuck is he turned into, yo? He did that shit while we were going to tell you, like, he ain't even let me turn on the camera yet or nothing yet. And he started his shit. So I'm like, well, if I was a passenger too, I'd be like, yo, what the fuck? But go ahead.
Yeah, exactly. Case, that's the whole point. That's the whole point. I'm done because I didn't write that, guys. Okay?
Exactly.
That was written by Wynn Lowry. I'm going to paraphrase some. Because sometimes, you know, when you listen to a song and you're like, oh my God, what did he say? I just put words in there that I felt sounded right too. Like, at one point, like, there's this, like, I think he, like, one word is off on that, probably, or maybe two, I don't know. With Lowry, if you see this, look me up, True Turtle Empire on Facebook.
He really respects your man. He does his shit perfectly good, man.
If you sue me, that's what I'm saying. I'm letting you know right now.
The thing is, like,
let you know right now, because I'm doing it on my performances.
You know what I'm saying? You said that piece so dope, right?
Like, and I tell people, that's why, right at the end, I'm like, at the end of the piece, I say, look, I understand. Thank you all for your respect and listening. I really appreciate it. If you actually like that, look up Whit Lowry's song, Wonder If You Wonder. And also, if you're just like me, you know, you can find me on Facebook by searching True Turtle Empire. You know, because I come off as real modest. I can't ever assume my ego. And I let people know about my open mic, so if they ever did want to hear a performance from me, then that's where you go, and that's where I won't recite it. But on the train, like, I remember this one guy, yo, with Larry, another reason why I got your back, bro. I called him my bro, I don't even know the guy. Basically,
yo, he'll see this shit somehow.
Perhaps, possibly.
That's what it's
about. But there was this guy, I was taking the train, I haven't even turtled yet. That's what I call it when I'm panhandling, I guess. I'm not really doing
that.
Don't
call it panhandling.
I don't know what it's called.
This thing is balls to me, man.
Yeah, but I call it turtling. So before I went to go turtle, I'm freaking about to just go through the turnstile and everything. And this guy pulls me over and says, yo, you recited with Larry, bro. I was like, yo. I now listen
Did
to him
say
because of you.
Like
yeah.
beat
no, no.
Like,
he said, I now listen to that song because of you. He tapped my shoulder and said, I now listen to that song because of you. And I was like, wow, really? I promoted? That's nice. I was like, cool, you got that. So if you got a little extra like on your video, you know, then I'm helping you. That's what that is. And that's just Subway. That's public. I'm just letting you know.
How long you been turtling, man?
I've been turtling for pretty much, like, literally the beginning of 2016.
Now, I know why you do what you do, listen, man. I'm on the same level as you, man. I really don't want to work for nobody no more, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, exactly.
You know what I'm saying? So I do if you want to call it a hustle, it's a hustle, but this is grinding. I'm out there on these streets all over the place, going to the venues, connecting with other people. Like, you know, I'm never stagnant.
He's now official member.
Yo, you've been to the
True Turtle Empire.
Yo, you've been to the crib. You see how fucking focused I am, man. And make sure that I'm doing everything possibly to expand the brand, take over promotion. But to meet you, man, is great, man. He got so many plans that I really wish we could hope we crunch him.
Yikes. Like there's this Four Turtle Friday.
Like the next Saturday Night Live type shit.
Yeah, I'm hoping for it.
Like he's trying to get me out of my element and
all I can do is dream and hope it comes true. And I've kind of already completed the first dream, which was just to host something, and that's like living what I'm doing.
So let's hold on to that. The next one, when we come back over this break, we're gonna go back to your dreams, man, your goals, your aspirations. You know what I'm saying? Yo. Turtle Will.
I talk too much is what you're saying.
On the Soap.TV series. You can find him on Facebook at True Turtle Empire. You can find me at Takeover Promotions, Dirty Promessa, Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. And that's what it is. It's Soap.TV series.
If any singers, rappers, poets, dancers, painters, or anyone who would like to be interviewed by Takeover Promotion and we find it interesting, please submit your bio into one of these emails or social networks. Thank you very much. Takeover Promotions.
We back on the Soap.TV series. I'm Dirty Promessa. I hope y'all like the intermission. When my boy saying go get her. You know what I'm saying? Turtle Will. We're up in Ornament Studios. It's the sponsor of Dutch Shouts, 381 Canal Place, Bronx, New York, 14451. This is Takeover Promotions, show that I produce, Dirty Promessa, called SOTHOT.TV Series. If y'all don't know about SOTHOT.TV Series by now, it's just an acronym of supporting other talented artists. And that's what I basically do as an artist myself. I started off with just, like, if I don't know, I just started off because I went to many venues, been a lot of venues, met a lot of promoters, stuff like that. And what I did, what I noticed is that in these venues, a lot of people at the time, they didn't have their cameras with them, you know what I'm saying? So I took advantage of that shit, you know what I'm saying? So people used to come up to me and be like, yo, you got my film? You got film on me, man? Because I seen you got the camera. I'm like, yeah, I got film of you. So that's how I started off with the Takeover promotion into my own small business. I'm the sole proprietor, Dirty Promessa, and I'm just happy to bring to you the SOTHOT.TV Series, man. This is like the third season. Turtle Will is the first one on the third season of this SOTHOT.TV Series. And what I'm doing is trying to produce and help out other talented artists by giving them promotions. I also do other things. I'm a videographer. And, that's how I met up with Turtle Will at his venue. And
Monday, the open mic and four Turtle Fridays.
Yeah. So that's, you know, I've been working with him, hard body, putting things out, local talent that comes and they shine and fucking touch the mic. With live DJ by DJ Tech One. Shout you know what I'm saying? Big shout out to him. 914 coming straight out of White Plains, dedicating his time to make sure we get a live DJ in there, we get the plugs.
He actually created the name for Turtle Fridays.
He did, right?
Yeah, I was like, really? He was like, yeah.
Turtle Friday basically is a big event that's happening on the 30th of December. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's tomorrow, right now. Get it in, right? I don't know. By the time they see this, man.
By the time they see it, it'll be over. Yeah.
But they'll be probably filming that over there. I really don't want to.
Sorry, they.
That's going to be like a Las Vegas night, you know what I'm saying? Because it's kind of menu. It's like, how you say it? Memory.
There's raffles, actually, and like a chance to win your own music video. So that's like something interesting that you don't get from other venues, you know?
And we got a gift card.
It's called the Friday Surprise because I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Mm-hmm. All right, man. We're doing that at the Haven SPX, 128 Alexander Avenue, Bronx, New York, 10451.
It might be relocated though.
Yeah, no. Well, the Haven's going one time.
Yeah, the Haven is still going to be a thing. Big shout out to Barry K.
Coolest white boy you ever see, man.
He's my white dad, actually. He's my white father, seriously.
But we came back, yo. We finished off. We wanted to know, what's some of your goals? Cause you always big me up, telling me I'm helping you out a lot with your support and just the things that you wanted to do. So,
well, I think I've already given my shout out to Chris Tucker and how my plan is to play James Carter in the remake of Rush Hour. Seriously, that's my job.
Mm-hmm.
I just see myself just in a better light. Like I want to do all the things that I've ever done as a kid, like the little fake movies I create with my toys, the little the drawings that I've done, because I'm also a cartoonist. That means I just draw cartoons. I'm not going to say I'm an artist, but I do cartoons and my own stuff.
Mm-hmm. And that's like, new to me.
I just love being able to create stories, and I just recently started really making up my story, you know, 2016, that's when it happened, and I was like, wow, like, yeah. Mm-hmm.
My goal is to survive through my dreams right now.
Because speaking of goals, I was talking about the rhythmistic Rose Angelica Lopez. Big shout out to you. She was a host to her own open mic. She let me in to her events and everything. And she went away to Miami recently because it was cold here. It was messing up the vibe, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And so she threw this big concert before she left, and I was able to attend. And it was in such a small space. It was a beautiful spot. And everybody was there. Everybody who had ever seen her, anybody who ever supported her through the years she's been progressing, and they were all there in this small, compact little spot standing. People were standing for this. And it was beautiful because I was like, this is her dream come true. Right. And now she's about to run out to Miami and pursue bigger dreams. And now you see me here at the SOTHOT.TV Series referencing Brooklyn in the house. And yeah, we're on the channels you skipped, so don't skip this one.
Man, okay. Right, tell them.
All right, I'm letting you know. Letting you know. It's public access, but all exposure is good exposure, so.
You can also see it on www.brickartsmedia.com/TV channel. I'm link 3, once again, every Thursday at 4 o'clock and at 11 p.m. You know what I'm saying? You can check out the Sota TV series, man. You know, I had to plug that in.
Of course. You have to put your logo
right
there.
It's stamping,
you know?
Turtle Empire, man. You can find
it. True Turtle Empire. I found out. It used to be Turtle Empire until I found out there's another Turtle Empire on Facebook. I was upset, man. Mm-hmm. I was angry. So I just said, you know what? Word. You think you the true Turtle Empire? All right. True Turtle Empire, and I just added the true in there, and I think it was when I reached like 303 likes, and I was like, I'm nobody, 303, wow, now it's up to 420.
Well, that's what I'm giving, you the exposure, man, you can get the exposure, bro.
Right now,
I'm introducing you to your face to the world, man, to the face of at least Brooklyn, man, Brooklyn all over the
Brooklyn
place.
Brooklyn in the house.
2017,
again, you can see me,
shit on Bronx,
again,
man.
You guys can see me literally on the train, like, I'm everywhere. On the D train, the B train, just like I love.
He be stomping his feet, dumb hard. Like,
see. As a matter of fact, I might be blowing up my spot for that recitement I do for Whit Lowry. So when you see me now and you see I'm like acting out, you're gonna be like, ah, it's this cat.
Yeah. Yo, with some of your goals, what is your goals like? What are you, man? Like, what is your title, man? Do you have a title?
I consider myself a verbal artist. You know what that means is if it can be written. It's
yeah, because you've been in the freestyle sessions too, man. You hold your own, yeah. But you always put in it, I don't freestyle.
But
you still be freestyling it. And you don't, you keep going and shit.
The thing about freestyling is I can freestyle. You have to freestyle what you believe. That's what I've learned.
Right.
I've learned when people freestyle, it's off the dome and it's just so creative and they're just
Lord
putting
Cipher,
the sentences. The Lord of the Cipher, man. He's one of my biggest
inspirations.
Yo, he
said some complex
shit, right? Exactly.
And that's freestyle.
Exactly.
Like, damn, his vocabulary is sick.
Exactly. Like, the Lord of the Cipher is a wonderful individual. And you see people like that who are able to just do it off the dome. My thing is they're believing in that. You know what I believe? That I can't do it as well as you. So I'm going to tell you how.
And what you always say? Saying that shit, what you always
you want me to,
say?
You want me to try to
freestyle? What you say? No, freestyle. What you be saying when you get on the mic after somebody
I'll be like, pass the mic.
You be like, yo, I like seeing other people here.
I like to see people. Oh, you're talking about the open mic.
Yeah,
when
yeah.
I do the thing. Oh, what I say is like, I literally, the reason why I love what I do is because now I throw an open mic. And I, like I said, I don't like to stroke my ego. So what I do with this open mic is I let people outshine me, and I love it. we had this dude, Arnabi, Japanese rapper. Big shout out to
him.
He came coming from Japan. What? Coming from Japan for the Monday mic. And he was the most exciting thing about it. And I was looking at him. I was like, yo, but I'm the host though.
Big shout out to Arnabi Chuma from Japan, the rapper. The hottest shit I like about him, he don't give up his shit. He'll talk in Japanese all day.
Shall ya?
You know what I'm
yes,
saying?
I say
rapping Japanese, talk to you in Japanese. Yo, big shout out to Arnabi because he's like on the first season of Soul Thought TV series, man. So I linked up with him. I said, yo, come do the open mic. And the rest is just history, man. Like, he just fucking flipped that whole shit over, man. Like, his energy, and you don't know what the fuck he's saying.
Sometimes. No.
His hooks, his choruses.
Yeah, his hooks are on fire. Like,
and Vero G.
Vero G,
out.
Yes.
You know what
she
saying?
Made a Christmas album. Because, you know, right now, as we're filming this, this is in December. It might be later when you see this, you know. But,
I did a video.
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Oh,
man.
Shout
there.
Out to Dirty Promessa.
I shot a video all downtown, midtown, on 43rd to Rockefeller, Rockefeller Center. Yo, we did the whole strip. We recorded everywhere. Yo, she's a trooper, man. Real grind. Big shout out to Real G. You can find her too on Facebook, man. Real G, man. You know what I'm saying? Yo, just fucking grind up, man. As a female, because she took me everywhere, man. Like, while we was filming the video, she was at the same time handing out her albums to people. So she's like, you don't mind following me and shit? I'm like, nah, I ain't know what I was in for, bro. We was just up there, I'm carrying a big ass camera everywhere. Two cameras and shit with light system, and I'm just, we all over the place, just picking up and going and shit, man. And that's how I see you, man, like, yo, working hard, man. You know what I'm saying? That's why I had to follow you and see what you how you do this, man. Like, is that, you know, it takes a lot to stand up in a single train and like fucking speak your words. Like,
first of all, cop.
We already got shouted out yesterday too, right?
Yeah,
like,
I'm cool.
By the conductor and shit.
I'm cool with cops. I'm cool with cops.
And she gave us a shout out to that. I told her, right? I
said,
shout out because
there's like panhandling is illegal. But here's the thing about panhandling. Is this.
Yeah. You
I'm just going to be real, man. I tell people, I understand if you don't want to donate. Understand I'm trying to earn a dollar. What that means is I can't earn one if I beg for one. So I'm not going to walk up to you like this, and I'll bend over to somebody. Well, that sounds so wrong, but think not in the gutter. Yeah, but anyway, like, and I'll do this right in front of somebody just like, I'm not going to do this.
Yo, you be point blank in their face.
I'm just looking at them. So you understand the awkwardness that I'm feeling right now. This way I would bring it to their attention that I get it. This is an awkward situation. Understand, I'm trying to make something better of myself, which is exactly why I won't beg.
And can I ask you one last question? Like, where you see yourself in 5 years? You're a young man, man.
The next 5 years. You're a young man. Actually, a big shout out to rapper East Move, because we actually... we're talking about this when we chilled. Like, we haven't chilled a lot recently. But
yo, if you didn't know, all of the studios are home of hip hop, man. You know what I'm saying? Yo,
East Move is a terrific
live,
MC.
Live up in here, man.
I need to bring him in. Yo, East Move, if you're watching this, I'm going to tag you in this, so I know you're going to watch it. Come through.
Yeah, come.
That's
all
that
the studios,
means.
Man.
Through,
music up in
through.
Here, man. Legends, man. You ready? All what? Creative crafting. They own sound.
And you live in Brooklyn, Smooth. You live in Brooklyn, so, you know, you already
oh,
know.
Oh, but Ultimate Studios in the Bronx.
Shout out to my hometown, I guess.
Yo, so, but you ain't but 5 years from now, what do you see?
Like I said, we was talking about it, and we see ourselves throwing this party on a yacht. Literally, on a yacht. I don't know how we're going to
do
it.
You know that shit can happen, right?
Yeah, I know. Which is why we were talking about this party that we would throw, because we saw this huge boat party, and we was just talking about one day we're going to make it, and we had just finished this Smooth Turtle Joint is what we called it, because I'm Turtle Will and he's East Smooth. We did this thing called Smooth Turtle Joint, and it's pretty cool. It's pretty much me DJ Khaled-ing. You know how DJ Khaled be like, we the best! Yeah. Like, I'm just like in the background, but I supply the chorus with my talk, and I also wrote out the skit that starts it off. You can find that through True Turtle Empire. And I did that through an app on phone.
Yo,
and I made the beat.
Listen, we got live audience in here. We also got Turtle Will's sister up in here. So she going to come back. Excuse that. She going to come back. She going to be on the present in front of the cameras. And we're going to come back with dirty questions. So
Dirty questions.
Man. You just, it's something random. You just say off the top of your head what you think about it. I'm going to give you just questions and shit. 10 of them.
All right.
It's going to be simple. Very shit. Cool. Like I said, so we'll be right back. So that TV series on Dirty Camessa.
Turtle Will.
Yeah. DP. Top. Shut my mouth. All about.
Welcome back to the Soul Talk TV series. I'm Brady Vanessa. This is True Turtle Will. You know what I'm saying? With True Turtle Empire. You can see him on Facebook. You can watch me, Dirty Vanessa, or Dirty Vanessa on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, as well as take all promotions on Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, all the whole thing, the whole nine. We're right now filming up in Ornament Studios, located in the Bronx at 381 Canal Place, sponsored by Dutch Shelves. And I thank you very much for that, man. And you know what I'm saying? It's a pleasure to do my business up in here to show that I'm striving amongst my peoples, you know what I'm saying? Right now, we have a new face.
Hey.
Onto the camera. This is Renee, right?
Rena.
Oh, I'm always... You know what about me? If I give you that name, I'm always going to recognize you by that.
Oh, no.
Y'all got to
follow
with that.
I'm going to respond to it. It's not me.
Rena's up on Soap That TV series, giving us permission to film her. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to give you We usually film amongst a live audience, man. We got High Life in the picture. We got Dutch Schultz in the background. We got Promise. We got Nancy on the behind on the cameras and everything. And you know what I'm saying? I'm just happy for the support and people to see.
Wasn't she in the Go Getter video?
Yeah, she was in the Go Getter. She was in the Go Getter video, you know what I'm saying? But it is what it is. But you cut me off. Terry Will also hosts his own open mic event. That's why he likes to take over. He don't like being quiet
take
at all.
Promotions. I'm taking over. I'm sorry, man. Taking over.
Listen, young talented man from the Bronx, man. You know what I'm saying? He's supporting the Toast.tv series. He's supporting Dirty Messy. He's supporting and supporting me basically by just being on the show, giving a live interview, and this is what I do, man. You can watch this on the Dirty Promessa subscription on YouTube. This will actually be aired sometime in the near future on brickartmedia.org, or you can see it on the Brooklyn Cable Network channels and stuff like that. So, yo, support Takeover Promotions. All I'm doing is trying to survive with the video camera, something that I'm skilled in and I'm certified in. But, you know, I'm happy to have Rena.
Yes.
And Turtle Will on the show. Freelancers with you, got the first. This is the first time I've freelanced. Usually I'm correct with reading people bios and writing everything, basically using the next minute.
I
work with you, you know, at the SPX, SPX Haven over there on 128th,
the
art gallery by Barry. Sponsored, that's my sponsor, by Get Barry K on 128th Alexander Avenue. We're doing a big event right there on the 30th, 8 to 1 in the morning. Autumn Studios is doing an event at the same time on the 30th for the 31st. That's New Year's, Dutch? That's New Year's?
It's going to be an event here. It's actually not Throne Bars. That's one of those parties we letting be thrown here or renting the place out for.
All right.
But, because I'll probably be at your event.
Okay. That's this Friday, man. It's going to be liquor served there, you know what I'm saying? It's a $10. We never ask. Listen, Monday open mic was free, baby.
Monday open
we
mic
we did that the second I got part
and
of
you
it.
And you can show up to the season finale of Monday Mic on the 2nd of January, which is next year.
They probably won't see this until next Thursday.
Probably, but if you are.
It is what it is. Yeah, there's a final, there's a cap on everything.
That can last
forever. But the friendship and the bond is going to carry us through, so we want to find, you know, that shelf's right there listening to everything right now. We can find another place to do an open mic, you know what I'm saying, and bring
I'm
in new talent and stuff like
that. I'm actually looking at the
like
Angel
that.
Of Harlem, and Angel of Harlem, if you're watching this, keep me in mind.
Mm-hmm. You know, there it is. So, what's your favorite color?
Green.
Your favorite number?
4.
3. Oh, No.
4 is awesome.
That's why I'm before you. That's why I'm next to the host.
Whatever.
Because 3 is valid. Because 3 is valid.
4 is awesome.
3. I'm William
Edward.
What's
the best thing you remember of your mom?
How funny she is. Our mommy's
yes.
Hilarious.
Yeah.
Hilarious.
Most definitely. She's a comedian. She's a comedian. She actually probably fulfills my spirit to do this because she's so in the entertainment.
Yes.
She's so into entertainment. So mm-hmm.
Hilarious.
Yes, she's just a comedy.
So you think you do acting?
Most definitely.
Yes.
Acting?
You too? I'm trying to get
minor.
I'm trying to be James Carter in the next Rush Hour remake.
Your
brother's
love
hilarious,
to be
man.
A sitcom actress, but like the supporting friend, not the main star. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's trying to get me to do skits, man.
I'm trying to do this on TV series. This is on copyright, right?
Takeover Promotion is copyright.
Yes, most definitely. So once I say this, know that it all falls.
That's why I told you
promotions.
I need the promotion.
So
man.
Listen, I have this series idea, and if you take it,
which
watch
one?
This, and know that it was taken from me, if it is ever taken. I have this series idea.
Wait. There's 10 questions, man. There's some extra. You see what I'm saying?
I told you. I'm sorry.
Yeah, finish it up. What we got? Oh, we way past our time.
I don't give them no ideas, though. You got to pay for that. That's on the limited. VIP.
No.
Showtime VIP.
No, but do you freestyle?
I freestyle about not freestyling.
Do you have any songs that's recorded?
Yes.
What about you, sis?
Oh, no. I'm not the singer. I like to lip sync.
When I say recorded, by the way, I just mean on a camera that I use for my computer. Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I in the future, probably, but right now, just camera.
No doubt. So once again, when you see yourself 5 years, that's for both of you. Will you see your friend in 5 years? Quit.
Don't say nada. I don't know.
I see myself in the next 5 years. Chris Tucker saying, yo, I saw this on Soul Tide TV. I saw it. I was like, oh, really? You saw it?
Yeah, dog, yo.
Wherever God takes me.
Maybe you're a missionary.
Doggy.
I'm sorry.
I'm not.
I'm sorry. He did say dirty.
I don't have
an answer. He did say dirty.
We're in the dirty pool.
I don't have
an answer. My favorite color.
Green.
I said green.
Yeah.
And I'm freelancing, man.
Okay.
I'm going to just end it off like this, and I hope y'all can both get it right. What show you on right now, man?
The Soul Tide TV series. Mm-hmm. And just play it behind me right here.
So that's what it is, man. We got a Soul Tide TV series.
Why is Turtle Will?
Oh, why the hell is your name Turtle Will? That's my last one, man.
Oh, because Ninja Turtles inspire family beyond blood. They show just because someone isn't in your bloodline don't mean they can't be family as well. They look at a giant rat as their father, see no diversity in that, and that is the type of world I try to create with every event that I do, with all the venues I've been doing with Monday Mike, Open Mike, and Four Turtle Fridays. The main thing that you'll get is that the vibe is always family oriented and just really cool. Everybody can just bounce off each other very well, and it's never awkward like on the trains.
Series man, Turtle Will. This is the last show of the season. Big shout out to Dutch Shelves, man. You know what I'm saying? You ready to do the thing? Yeah. Get the camera ready, man. Yo, this ain't possible without my boy over here, man. He's right here. Dutch Shelves, man.
It's good, bro. Thanks for coming out, everybody. Love, light, peace, and joy.
Two.
You know, it's about 6 years ago. I just want to tell you about this group of folk. I know, and we've grown. They know more about me. It just kind of kills to think they know me better than the family. Now, I've always been one for the truth. And if you're listening to this piece while it's new, this here's some shh I never told you. They say friends come and go. It's just something I was told. But my people stay with me because that's the way I roll. I don't roll up my weed. I smoke socially. I invite company and they roll it for me. And we'll puff up some trees because I'm adopting family. Those friends come and leave and you can't disagree. I got a niece. And we ain't even blood, yo. I just refer to her uncle as my realest bro. But with brothers, I got a few of those. There's JT, Toby, MVP, Senpai, and Mento. And I ain't out here bagging no hoes. I think bitches got fleas, so I leave them alone. Cause all the girls in my circle, they all own souls. It's funny how my circle is still small, but I'm watching it grow. But goddamn, it's unique. Brought someone new to the team. I remember meeting a girl who brought me a pen with blue ink, and I used it to write this piece. So when I blow off my steam, you'll feel it in the highest degree. It was summer in 2016, that's when it happened to me. I started paying attention to blessings and understanding what they mean. And sure, yeah, really built up a team, and we got our issues, and that's why we're family. I know this girl named Titan. I swear she be fighting pacifist sometimes. Spiritually, she's enlightened. She's on a Libra air sign. Now I've witnessed her flying. I mentioned them people in my life who ever caught me crying. I said, why? Life's so hard, I'ma quit. Well, self-stop being a bitch, and we'll admit it. You got allies in this shit. Some people are out there to help you lose, and some just want you to win. That's what a family beyond blood is. I love my real family, though. The blood ones, too. Yeah. Love you guys.
DP! Top! Shut my mouth. All about. Give my protection, my civil right. It's my right. Down to sight, out to sight. Throwing that eagle's height, eagle's height. Take out water in life. Watering lights, pray for better life. Poor man life.